1 Corinthians chapter 12, verses 4 through 6. There are diversities of gifts, but the same Spirit. There are differences or diversities of ministries, but the same Lord. And there are diversities of activities, but it is the same God who works all in all. But the manifestation of the Spirit is given to each one for the profit of all. If growth really happens, spiritual children will grow to realize it's not all about them. They will notice a hurting world around them and will change from being self-focused kids to spiritual youngsters that genuinely care about others. They will follow Jesus Christ, who did not come to be served, but to serve. Serve. In what ways? The Holy Spirit equips people for service, for ministry. He gives gifts. How will spiritual youngsters know what their gifts are? They all have some innate talents, but are those spiritual gifts? The Holy Spirit may want to turn someone's natural gifts into spiritual gifts. But what if he wants to give someone totally new gifts? How will they recognize them? In the old days, parents used to send their youngsters off to become disciples, to learn from professionals. Those masters knew something about discipleship. If they recognized a child wasn't gifted in their particular area of work, in order to avoid frustration, they would call the parents and recommend a shift in order to align their work with their gifts. The same applies to spiritual gifts. It is crucial to match the right gift with the right ministry. And for that, spiritual youngsters need guidance. They need you to help them find ministry opportunities. Yes, help them volunteer and try out different activities. Then discuss and listen carefully to their impressions. If they discover their giftedness, validate it. If not, help them to prayerfully continue the search until they find it, and then empower them to become full-fledged ministers for Jesus Christ.